Hello, this is Dirk Mittler, and this screencast will demonstrate how the IDE called Geany can be used to manage multi-file projects under Linux. And so, in order for that really to be practical, one of the packages that, or one of the extensions of Geany which must be installed is an extension called the Project Organizer extension. So if I look in my little package manager, one of the things I will discover is that I not only have Geany installed according to Synaptic, but I have a small number of plugins installed. And if one of these is the Project Organizer plugin. And what it specifically allows Geany to do is to remember a set of build instructions that are specific to one project without becoming the default instructions for Geany. So if I open Geany to a project which I already have, which was a multi-source code project, one of the things I'm going to do right now is I'm going to edit the header file just to make sure that Geany will in fact recompile everything or recompile what needs to be compiled. And at the same time, I just want to point out each of my source files includes the header file, but it's wrong for one source file to include the other source file. So including a header file in a source file is fine. Including another header file in another header file is fine. But including a source file in a source file is not fine. Now, one of the things that the plugin, that the Project Organizer plugin adds to the user interface of Geany is a project menu, which is currently opened to a project, which I already had. Now, in order to compile a multi-file project under Linux, by default, one would need to create a makefile. But what people might not realize is that Geany can then be the text editor to edit the makefile. So the way one would do this is one would add a new file to Geany, one to the Geany project. One would then save it as a file named makefile. And once one has done so, one would be free to write one's makefile using the same IDE that one used before to create the source files and the header file. Geany does not recognize the syntax of these makefiles, by the way. But because this is a project that uses Boost, one of the preferred methods by which a Boost project can be compiled is using JAM files. So this project already has a JAM file, which is called JAM root. Here it is. And so the only thing that needs to be done is that Geany needs to be given specific instructions on using this JAM file rather than using a makefile. So in order to do that, first of all, a source file has to be selected. JAM root cannot be selected. The makefile cannot be selected because Geany has no special recognition of those files. But once a source file has been selected, under project, there are properties which override the normal build commands. So in gray, one would see the build commands that are defaults for the program. And one can just reset either of these as belonging to the project. And normally the build command to build the entire project is make, because that's what invokes a makefile. But what I can easily do is I can change this build command to b2, because that is the command one would give on a modern Linux computer to invoke JAM root, or a JAM file named JAM root. So once I have changed the make command to b2, what I can simply do, having selected a source file in the correct project folder, one source file is called roots001.cpp, the other source file is called interface.cpp, I can click on this little down arrow, and this little down arrow will expand, and one of the entries will be make all. So once I give this command, it will rebuild several of its targets simply because I changed the contents of a header file. And because I already practiced this in advance, I can anticipate that this will be a success. So no surprise, the compilation finished successfully, and there was not even a complaint about the fact that the command B2 was being given in a certain directory, and that the output is the output of having updated seven targets. Now, one of the things that I can do and should do is I should go fetch the library that was created, because this project did not create an executable as its build target. It took the roots 001 source file and created an object file. And then it cre took the interface source file and created an object file. And then, as the jam root file was specifying, it linked this into a library called rroots.so, which was specifically set up by Boost to be usable, to be importable within a Python project. So just to verify that this library was in fact built. The time right now is Monday on the 29th of November, and it's shortly before noon. And so I can open the project folder and I can go into bin where the jam file would leave its build project, its build results. And there is a file here called roots.so, spelled with two R's. And if I look at the properties, sure enough, it was built Monday, November 29th, shortly before noon. So the thing to do next would be to copy this particular library that I just built successfully, and to paste it into my Python program where I had already previously created one. And sure enough, it's going to tell me that a 673.6 kilobyte file is going to replace a 673.6 kilobyte file. Now, in order to test that this library actually forms an available module within my Python application is not what this video is about, because the next thing that I would do is I would run the Python script to see whether I get any error messages or whether this particular module that the Python script imports will behave properly. But this particular video is not about that subject. It was just about how to get a multi-file project to compile properly. That being a C++ project managed by the IDE that's called Geany, which is a very simple, lightweight IDE that is closer to being a text editor, really, than it is to being an IDE. So anyway, thank you for watching. Thank you for your attention. That will be all.